Hello everyone. Today we will be continuing study of bridge engineering. Concept of pre-stressed secondary internal force. The initial internal forces generated at the redundant constraints due to various forced deformations of statically indeterminate structures are correctly referred to as secondary internal forces. The pre-stressed concrete simply supported beam only produces free deflection deformation and pre-stressed eccentric moment under the action of pre-stressed force, but does not produce secondary moment, as shown in the figure. The continuous beam has redundant constraints that restrict the free deformation of the beam body, if not only generates vertical secondary reactions at the redundant constraint, but also generates secondary moments at the beam body, as shown in the figure. So its total moment expressed by the following formula. Principle of equivalent load method. Basic assumptions. In order to simplify the analysis, the following assumptions are made for pre-stressed concrete beams. Friction loss of pre-stressed reinforcement is ignored. The pre-stressed reinforcement runs through the whole length of the member. The cable curve is approximately regarded as changing according to the quadratic parabola and the curvature is flat. Equivalent load of curved pre-stressed cable. As shown in the figure, the inclination angle of the left end of the pre-stressed concrete simply supported beam with curved cables is set A, and the distance from the central axis is EA, and the inclination angle of the right anchor head is set B. The eccentricity is EB, and the sag of cable curve in the midspan is F. The symbol in the figure specifies that the eccentricity E of the cable force is positive upward and negative downward. The upward load is positive and the reverse is negative. Based on the above symbol, the expression of this cable curve is as follows. The eccentric moment M of the pre-stressed tendon to the central axis is as follows. According to the formula in the course of mechanics of materials, subtract the two formulas to get the following results. Comparing these two formulas, the following results are obtained. The above formula indicates that the direction of load concentration Q is upward, and it is positive. Delta C is the change of cable curve inclination, as shown in the figure. We call this uniformly distributed load Q the equivalent load of the pre-imposed force on the beam. Its total load Q along the full span length must be exactly balanced with the vertical downward component of the preload at both ends. Equivalent load of broken pre-stressed cable. According to the same principle, the cable force length equation with broken length cable can be written as shown in the figure. According to the formula, the shear force distribution diagram of this simply supported beam can be drawn, and The shear force distribution diagram is exactly consistent with the result of P effect of a vertically upward concentrated force acting on the C section of the beam, which can be expressed by the following formula. Application of equivalent load method. Calculation steps. Now, take the two span continuous beam as an example to summarize its calculation steps. The initial moment diagram of the beam is drawn according to the eccentricity EI of the pre-stressed cable curve and the pre-stressing force without considering the constraint effect of all supports on the beam. According to the cable layout, the equivalent load value is determined by the formula as follows. The section internal force of continuous beam under equivalent load is solved by force method or finite element method program, and the bending moment value obtained is called total bending moment, M total, which includes the initial pre-moment M0. Calculate the secondary moment M times of the section, and the calculation formula is as follows. Example, for two equal span continuous beams with constant cross-section, the layout diagram of the cable curve is shown in the figure. The eccentricity E equation of each section of cable curve is listed in the following table. The end preload is known. Try to find the total bending moment and secondary moment of section B of the middle pivot point. Solution. Since the structure and the pre-applied force are symmetrical to the section B of the middle fulcrum, half of the structure can be taken for analysis, and the section B is regarded as a fixed end. The calculation steps are as follows. Draw the initial pre-moment diagram of the pre-applied force, as shown in the figure. Calculate the equivalent load of the preload. The result of an angle of section A to D is as follows. Applying the formula, the equivalent load result of A to D section is as follows. The result of an angle of section D to B is as follows. The equivalent load results of segment D to B are as follows. Calculation of total pre-moment of fulcrum B. The calculation diagram is shown in the figure, which can be decomposed into two simple working conditions in the figure, and then calculated by applying the formula given in bridge design and calculation. As shown in the figure, the bending moment calculation formula of fulcrum B is as follows. In the calculation formula of bridge design and calculation, Q is positive downward and negative upward, so the value of Q1 should be substituted for the example, and the calculation results are as follows. For figure E, the calculation formula of root section bending moment is as follows. The total bending moment of fulcrum B is as follows. Secondary moment of fulcrum B. The result from the formula is as follows. The concept of anastomotic bundle. Take the bending moment diagram like under the actual load as the line of the beam curve. which is a line of coincident beam. At this time, the external load is thus balanced by the preload. This can be proved by a simple example, as shown in the figure. It is a two-span continuous beam bearing uniformly distributed load Q, as shown in the figure. The bending moment calculation formula for the left span of two equal span continuous beams is as follows. Substitute these two formulas to obtain the calculation formula of equivalent load. It can be seen from the formula that the Q effect is equal to Q and the direction is opposite. The load on the beam is completely balanced. The same conclusion can be obtained for other structures.
Okay, that's all for today. Goodbye, class.